Good morning guys, today's video is on a ps3 slim that is 3003A model, and as you can see that HDMI cable is connected and power cable is connected and standby red light is visible. I will press it to turn it on. No HDD light blink and it keeps itself on for some seconds and as you can see that there is no display on the TV. And now it is off. So let's start. We will open it and it is hanged. It shuts off by itself after a few seconds. Yes, now it is off and eject beep is available. Let's check it. First, I have to check for the power supplies. I will start from here. Yes, it is. Thank you. GPU input oscillation is fine, it is also fine, and the output voltage are available. And this is the second power supply for GPU, and its output is available. This is the GPU internal RAM or internal component power supply, it is also fine. So I need to figure out the fault, and as you listen, the three or four beeps, because it shuts off due to the overheat, it means the thermal data from this chip and from this chip is going well to the south bridge. We need not to check the circuit. So I need to figure out the fault. Here I can, now I can check for the processing of this NAND and south bridge and this CPU. For this, first of all, I will check for the clock here. Yes, clock is available, and at this and the second test point, I will give you one new tip, that whenever this high level 3.2 level trace line would not go down, it means this processing is not going to complete. Here you can see again that whenever I will turn it on, it will go up and it should go down again if the processing completes, but it is not. So here I should check for the processing data. Yes, processing starts and stops. So guys, now it is somehow clear that the problem is with this CPU, because it is not bricked. If it is bricked, then the green light would not stay on for as long as it is going to be on. The green light will turn off right after 5 seconds or 3 seconds, but it stays on for a longer time, so it determines that it is also not bricked. So I think the problem is beneath this CPU. It stops processing after a while. Let's try to reflow it first. Okay, for this, first of all, I have to remove this cell from its socket, because it can be lost due to the overheat temperature. And as I can see, that this board is neat and clean, no more dust underneath this processor, so we need not to wash it. Just apply thermal paste. Because it is a thick paste, so I have to preheat it so as to spread this thermal paste all the way underneath this processor. Some of the boards may left dry, and they would not be reflow as good at as they should be, so that this flux paste must be all the way underneath this processor. Then it will be all the way spread. I can see the flux paste from these corners. Yes. Sides I can see, it's okay. Now let's go to our reflow machine. This is my sleeping bed. Thank you.
keep it so you do it until and unless it floats on the boards. Let me check. It is still high.
First, I will put this cell back in its socket and then 12-volt jack standby jack. Here now I must connect the HDMI cable and this power on a standby strip. Turn it on and we'll go for the display. Hopefully we can see the display on the TV. Yes. So guys, that was the story, and I hope you have learned one more fault how to determine a fault. So thank you very much, and please subscribe and keep watching my videos. Goodbye.